One of the funnest things about being in the rainforest is being out there when the sun first rises and you get that warmth from the dawn and all the birds begin to call.
I got roped in because I'm a fly scientist, and so there's of course going to be tons of flies there.
I'm really excited because it's the first big rainforest expedition for the Cal Academy team. We've all worked independently over the years, but not as a group.
We're going to Penang, which is actually an island off of mainland Malaysia. On the island, there's a little hill called Penang Hill, and it's primary forest, meaning it's never been cut down before.
All of Malaysia is being cleared, and it's a really scary thing. The palm oil industry has totally annihilated tropical forests over there. This site is within a 15-minute access of almost 2 million people. That sounds almost like a conundrum. How can we keep it safe? But at the same time, it's a great challenge and opportunity to me as a scientist, because I think it would be a great tool for rainforest education and conservation.
We built the park to provide people with a means to reconnect themselves back into the natural environment, something that we've seen waning over the years.
We hope one day that Penang Hill would be a UNESCO Biosphere Reserve, not too distant future. That will be, and it will be a model for, you know, people to look at not only the conservation, but also on how people are utilizing the biodiversity in a sustainable manner.
One of the things that we want to do is get up there and try and survey the biodiversity. And what we want to do is just get a baseline, some information about what's there so that they can use it, so that they can monitor what's there over the long term and make sure that they're doing a good job of taking care of that biodiversity.
There's so many people coming on the trip that have different areas of expertise. Somebody that studies birds, somebody that studies flies, somebody that studies ants and ferns and everything that you can imagine. The success of any expedition relies on your ability to find local expertise, people that really know the place and really know the organisms living in that place. And luckily in this case, in the case of our Penang Hill survey, a lot of that work has already been done for us.
In this case, we come in as experts from afar, but the real owners and stewards of the conservation are the local people.
People were working out all day and all night, you know, and enjoying, I think they were enjoying themselves and working together among the local as well as the foreign scientists.
It's really interesting because everybody will have a different schedule. The frog folks might need to be out at night, and rain might shut down some groups, but it might turn on other groups. You have to know what you need to get and what data you need and be really focused on getting your portion of the work done. But then there's usually a lot of downtime, and that's when you try and see what other folks are doing, and you can learn from them, you can help them, you can glob onto their, you know, their expedition team.
We're gonna come back with a lot of flies. And we're going to spend a lot of time under the microscope just sorting, and considering there's about 150,000 known species of flies, many, many more undiscovered. We know so little about them, so expeditions like this provide just a little glimpse into this, you know, incredibly important group of life on Earth.
Because we're losing things at a rate faster than scientists can discover them, due to climate change and due to loss of habitat, we really have a fundamental duty to try to document the remainder of life on Earth. Because until we know what's out there, we can't really figure out how to protect it or how to put in place rules or regulations or just practices that will help ensure that those species continue into the future.
We certainly know that a healthy rainforest keeps us alive, so we need to keep species that are part of this healthy fabric of life. But it's a big challenge to communicate that, and what better way maybe than bringing 2 million Malaysians to their very own forest, climbing in their very own canopy walkways, and seeing all the cool things that might get discovered there.
Not only do we want people to come here and learn about the rainforest, learn about this important ecosystem, but we also want them to leave this place with some kind of link back into what they can do to assist in the conservation effort.